Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube. And this morning, we're going to be talking some golf. We're going to be talking some travel. I've got some incredible deals on travel for you just a little bit later in the show. Joining me in the studio, filling in for Mike McGann this morning, is Dawn. It's nice to see you, Dawn. Thank you. And we will have joining us in just a few minutes, who she's running, must have overslept a little bit this morning, golf tournament director, co-host Doris Muscarello. She'll be sneaking in any minute now. We're keeping an eye peeled. And in just a few minutes, we will be chatting with our guest who's in studio today, direct from Papa's Pilar Rum in Key West, Florida, their community director, Mike Schmidt. How you doing, Mike?
Good morning. How you doing?
I am doing great. Thank you for joining us. And it's never too early in the morning to have a sip of rum, right?
Nope. We got to start the day off right.
I suppose so. And we're going to learn a lot more about your rum and the whole story, the fascinating story behind Papa's Pilar Rum. I'm fascinated by it. But first, what we're going to do is we're going to talk a little bit about golf and what's going on in the world of golf. And even though the year is kind of winding to an end, there's still things happening. Congratulations last week on the PGA Tour. Ludvig Åberg, he tied the 72-hole scoring record and recorded his first PGA Tour win. He's only been out of college for 6 months. He's already won a Ryder Cup. Now he's won a PGA event. 24 years old, from Sweden originally, graduated Texas Tech 6 months ago. He says, in short, it's been beyond his dreams. I think that would capture it. Also, the LPGA Tour, they played in Naples, and Amy Yang won. It was her first win on American soil on the LPGA Tour. She picked the right event. It was their season-ending event with the largest winner's share all year. Or ever, tied, I think. It was $2 million for Miss Yang. Congratulations to her. Not congratulations, though, to Paul Azinger, who is no longer going to be doing the commentary on NBC. They offered him a nice pay cut, and he promptly said no. He offered to negotiate for a different amount, and they also said no. And I think... You know, it's funny. I was just talking with Dawn a few minutes ago about the media and how difficult it is these days. And TV media, they're all cutting back. They're getting rid of the folks who've been there forever, the people who are making the huge salaries. He's going to be replaced by a fellow who's been with them for a while, Kurt Byram. Not quite the same name or credentials as Paul Azinger, and obviously not the same rate of salary either, I guess, and that's why. Also, we had spoken last week about TGL, that new golf league that's just down the road from us in Palm Beach Gardens, headed up by Tiger Woods and Rory McIlroy. The wind and rain caused their roof to collapse where they're going to be playing their events, and sure enough, they've had to postpone the league opening, which was supposed to happen this January. Now they're going to have to wait an entire year, and they said they'd rather do it right than, you know, rushing it, so... it's unfortunate. Rory, he also stepped down from the board of advisors for the PGA Tour. He says he's got too much on his plate, and it's kind of taken the focus away from his playing. So Tiger, on the other hand, hasn't had enough on his plate lately, so he is going to be making a comeback this coming week, playing in his own event in the Bahamas for the first time in a long time. He also announced this week that he's going to be playing in a couple of weeks up in Orlando with his son in the what used to be the father-son. It's now the grandparent, grandson, grandmother, mother, who knows. But they love playing with family and kids. Also, congratulations, some awards. Lilia Vu won the Player of the Year on the LPGA Tour. And Athaya Thitikal, she won the Vare Trophy for the lowest scoring average. I had mentioned that Rory McIlroy dropped off the PGA Tour. He's been replaced by Jordan Spieth. Congratulations to him. I'm sure that he'll probably quit soon, too. It's a thankless job, I get the feeling. Patrick Cantlay's head and hat has been in the news yet again. At the Ryder Cup, he was all over the news for refusing to wear his hat. Rumor had it that he wasn't getting paid to wear his Ryder Cup hat, so he wouldn't wear it. Well, the hat he was getting paid to wear by Goldman Sachs, they're not going to pay him the reported like more than $1 million a year that he got to wear their logo on his hat. And now will he be going hatless or be finding a new sponsor? Who the hell knows? We'll keep an eye on that. Joost Luiten, he played last week on the DP World Tour, got upset, threw a club, got stuck in a tree. It got worse. He threw another club to try and get that one down. That got stuck in the tree. He threw another club to get that one down. That got stuck in the tree. He finally gave up, played with 11 clubs, and finished second to last. And I think the moral of the story is don't throw your clubs at all into trees. All right, what we're going to do is we're going to take a very, very quick break, and then we will be back, and we will be chatting with Mike Schmidt. He's the community director for Papa's Pilar Rum. You're not going to want to miss it. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Old man Donald Ross, he never took one day off. He never met a field he didn't lie.
Hi, golf and travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand. And when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
Doris Muscarella here. When I'm not co-hosting the Golf and Travel Show, I'm Southeast Florida's leading business and certified golf tournament consultant. I provide comprehensive solutions to all aspects of a golf tournament. From planning, management, marketing, administration, and logistics, I take care of the big picture or the smallest detail. With a passion for golf combined with years of experience as a golf tournament and event consultant, I organize events that exceed expectations and raise the bar of excellence. Your business or charity deserve no less. If you're ready to host a remarkable golf tournament that will leave your clients, players, donors, and spectators in awe, call me, Doris Muscarella, at 954-240-4853. That's 954-240-4853. Or simply visit my website, golfcharitytournaments.com. That's golfcharitytournaments.com.
It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle.
And we are back. And I'm excited because I happen to like to drink rum, especially when I'm on the golf course. It's I was speaking to our guest a little bit earlier. I play early in the morning, and I'm the kind of drinker that likes the little umbrellas in my drink. And having a little bit of fruit juice and rum in the morning or the afternoon as well is kind of my thing. But, I'm not a rum snob at this point, and I really want to get educated and learn a little bit more about the finer things in the rum world, and I thought today would be a perfect opportunity to do so. So to learn a little bit more about rum and Papa's Pilar Rum in particular, we have none other than Mike Schmidt, the community director of Papa's Pilar Rum, with us right here in the studio. How are you doing this morning, sir?
I'm doing well. Thank you very much for having me.
Hopefully you had a pleasant and hearty Thanksgiving.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
A little rum involved, I bet.
Of course.
I need to get like a recipe maybe to cook like a turkey with rum. I think that would be appropriate.
Hemingway daiquiri is definitely one of my favorites.
Well, or ham. I guess we have Christmas coming up, too. So there's another opportunity to combine rum and a festive holiday, right?
Of course, yeah. We have a lot of different recipes on our website. So if you're interested, you can check those out.
And, of course, I'm sure you have all the stories, but why don't we briefly just hear a little bit about the background? I mean, it's an interesting name for a product. It makes all the sense in the world when you stop and think about it, but why don't you tell us why Pappas Pilar Rum exists and the story behind it?
Yeah, so we have definitely an interesting story. We're named after Ernest Hemingway himself. Papa was a self-proclaimed nickname, and Pilar was the name of his beloved boat. Mm-hmm. So we named it Pappas Pilar Rum. We teamed up with the Hemingway family, and their proceeds go to the Hemingway Foundation. And we do a lot with conservation and community. We are involved with Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation, Eye Care, Reef Restoration, and a lot of other cool projects in the community.
So besides feeling good while drinking rum, you could truly feel good about supporting this rum.
Of course, yeah. There's always a cause behind.
So explain a little bit about, I've seen your blonde rum and your dark rum, and why don't you tell people a little bit about what the differences are and what it is that makes Papa Pilar's rum different from the other ones that are on the market?
Yeah, so just like Ernest Hemingway, he was an adventurous, and we source our rums from all around the world, just like Papa sources adventures. And we, source our rums from the Caribbean and all over. And then we have a master distiller, Ron Call, that, makes his own little special blend to create what we have with Papa's Pilar.
And when you're talking about a quality rum or a premium rum, what are the important factors? I mean, obviously, there's the flavor, there's the taste, there's the smoothness. I'm not an alcohol expert. So when somebody's going to take a sip of Pappas Pilar rum, what are they tasting? What's the sensations? What is it that they're looking for?
There's a lot of different taste notes that make our rum a lot different than the other rums. Like our blonde rum has a lot of flavor, has a lot of color. We don't strip a lot of the flavor out. So it's got a lot of citrus, vanilla, a lot of nice tasting notes that make a sipping rum or a nice mixing rum.
And then we were discussing that too. For people like me who are not real alcohol aficionados, people will look down on me if I take a decent quality of alcohol and I mix it with anything. Is that a sin?
No, it's not a sin. Whatever it takes for you to enjoy our product, everyone has their different taste profiles. And that's why we have a lot of different flagship products. We have a blonde, a dark that's finished in a sherry cask barrel, and then also a dark that's finished in a rye barrel. So just depending on your taste profile, we have a lot of different flavors, and you can mix them or enjoy them over the rocks, like a Manhattan or, an old fashioned, mm-hmm. even a daiquiri or a coffee, espresso at the end of the night. It was really good with our rum. It adds a lot of extra flavor. So, it definitely gives that drink an extra highlighted profile.
Now,
taste.
I always knew or believed that rum was made from sugar. But these days, alcoholic products sometimes are not as traditional as they used to be. I mean, is rum always made from sugar, or is it sometimes made from something else?
That's its core ingredient. And then, we add some molasses and different ingredients, and there's a scientific process that goes behind it.
That's for the geeks, right?
Yeah, exactly. But what makes our rum so enjoyable is we do have a complex, I would say, algorithm of how we get our taste profile to match and where we source our rums from all around the world. And, that's what gives it its really good flavor and taste.
Now, you mentioned that there's several different types that you have, but you also were telling me earlier that you have a tasting room so people can actually sit down and, I guess, get a flight of Pappas Pilar and so you can actually taste the difference.
Yeah, well, we have a really unique distillery down in Key West where we have a Hemingway library where you can go in at any time. Any of the tourists coming in on their cruise ships or just down there on vacation can pop in and have a rum cocktail at one of our, tasting rooms. Or we also have like distillery tours that you can sign up for and learn all about the process a little bit deeper if you're interested. We also have like a merchandise room where you can just go in and shop. Once a year, we release a distillery reserve that's only released and available in Key West. So if you're in Key West, make sure to stop by our distillery, pick up a distillery reserve, and maybe put it on the top shelf for another, you know, special, you know, evening to mm-hmm. enjoy, because it's a limited release. And, you know, we have a lot of cool stuff come out every year. So if you're interested, you could sign up for our Hemingway Social Club. And that'll just to give you any heads up of any new products coming out. We do a legacy we release once a year, so that's a limited release, you mm-hmm. know. So over the years, you'll have a pretty nice collection of, you know, unique limited releases, and we're always just trying to be innovative. And, you know, part of that is being part of the community and getting out there and meeting people like yourself and Doris, and becoming part of the community helps us sell rum. It spreads the word, and we like to get out there and know everybody, and, you know, find out where our niche is.
Yes, you had mentioned that. So now you met Doris because you sponsor some of her tournaments, right? So you get out there on the golf course and people have an opportunity to taste your product?
Yes, sir. Yeah, so we teamed up with Doris. We met her during one of the events that she was hosting, and thought it was a great opportunity to partner up and help us get involved in some more of the golf community. Golf's, you know, big part of travel. People are fishermen and golfers and hunters and, you know, just adventurous. So it all kind of ties in together, and we like to, you know, get out in the community and see, you know, see and meet new people.
Seeing people. And speaking of seeing people, Doris, did you oversleep this morning? It was a rough night last night, huh?
It was. I ate too much turkey and drank too much Papa's Pilar rum.
There you go. So we're almost done with the segment, and the last thing that I wanted to address, and maybe you can phrase it the way you would like to so that you could take part in this, the holidays are coming up. So what about, I mean, I'm looking at this beautiful presentation of Papa's Pilar. Where can people find Papa's Pilar locally if they'd like to give, you know, gift giving for the holidays? A website, can people purchase it? This is the time that people want to share goodness and good spirits.
For sure.
You know, I guess, you know, good spirits disqualifies that. So why don't you explain a little bit about how people can find it and how people can gift it?
Yeah, so if you would like to, you know, shop at your local liquor store, we're at ABC, Crown, Total Wine, all the major liquor stores, and also you can find us on shoppapaspilarrum.com.
Okay, and one last time, so you were drinking last night Papa's Pilar rum, and what was your experience like?
Oh, spectacular. I love both of the brands, and you have mixers and all that stuff, so don't miss out on this holiday season with Papa's Pilar rum.
From somebody who knows. All right, what we're going to do is we're going to take a very quick break, and then we're going to talk a little bit about some travel news and some deals I found on travel, and you won't want to miss it. Just make sure if you're drinking Papa's Pilar, you're not driving. That's all I can say.
Yes.
We'll be right back.
The older and deeper in debt. St. Andrew, don't you call me, because I can't go. I owe my soul to the country club pro.
Travel listeners, it's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand, and when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999, or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
Doris Muscarella here. When I'm not co-hosting the Golf and Travel Show, I'm Southeast Florida's leading business and certified golf tournament consultant. I provide comprehensive solutions to all aspects of a golf tournament. From planning, management, marketing, administration, and logistics, I take care of the big picture or the smallest detail. With a passion for golf combined with years of experience as a golf tournament and event consultant, I organize events that exceed expectations and raise the bar of excellence. Your business or charity deserve no less. If you're ready to host a remarkable golf tournament that will leave your clients, players, donors, and spectators in awe, call me, Doris Mascarella, at 954-240-4853. That's 954-240-4853. Or simply visit my website, golfcharitytournaments.com. That's golfcharitytournaments.com.
And we are back, and as promised, a little bit of travel news for you. This week I noticed that the airlines are going to be making a record $118 billion, that's billion with a B, dollars in junk fees, in spite of President Biden trying to crack down on it. And that's a lot of money in junk fees, so just be careful. Obviously, when you see a great deal, read all the fine print, look at the bottom line, and then make your decision. Speaking of junk, they charge you a lot of money for your suitcase to check it, and then they lose it.
I've had that experience.
Well, it seems that actually only about 0.5% of all checked luggage gets lost, but when you look at the millions of people that travel, that ends up being a lot of lost luggage. And people put really stupid things, I have to say, sometimes in their suitcases, like very expensive things, not thinking they're going to lose it. Well, there was a story this week in NPR radio I heard about there's a business or a guy that actually buys all of that lost luggage and then resells it. And it's in, where is he located? It's in Alabama. And I mean, the most expensive thing, it seems, are Rolex watches that they sell.
Wow.
But it's set up like a department store, and I think they said the most expensive thing they sold was the Rolex for $32,000. It was worth $64,000.
Wow.
But, it seems like quite an interesting business. So it's in Scottsboro, Alabama. It's called Unclaimed Luggage. They've been in business since 1970 selling all this stuff. So if you're looking for a bargain, or if you're looking for – actually, I think there was one story where one guy went and bought ski boots for his girlfriend because she lost hers. And he brought them home to her, and her name was in the boots. He actually ended up not knowing.
Wow.
He actually bought the ski boots that she had lost. They were hers. So anyway, how about some deals on travel? TravelZoo.com is a place where I sometimes find some hotels or packages. I recently, just 2 weeks ago, was in New Orleans, had a great time, walked past this hotel that is like the biggest, nicest hotel that's right on Bourbon Street. So for those of you, not me, but the people that truly want to live on Bourbon Street for a few days, I would recommend the Royal Sonesta New Orleans. Weekdays right now as cheap as $139 a night. It's a 4-star hotel. So if you don't mind being in the middle of all the craziness, I would recommend that. Go to TravelZoo.com and you can find that deal.
Good deal.
It is a good deal. On the weekend, it might be as much as $189. Everything is a little bit more on the weekend. I think I had mentioned I paid $89 a night for my room. It was a little bit off Bourbon Street, which I preferred, but it was the size of like a closet. So, and it didn't even have a closet.
Yeah.
It was, I think I was sleeping in a closet, but didn't have a closet. Or, yeah. I don't know.
I'd rather pay the extra money.
Well, that was my decision too. So next time I might pay $50 more a night and have a bigger room. But it was an adventure. Airfare deals. The best way for you to find these is go to Google Flights. Googleflights.com, put in where you're leaving from, where you're going to, look at it month by month, because these deals are certain days every month, but not every day. So again, you don't want to be ripped off, you want to get the deal. How about San Juan, Puerto Rico, one of my favorite places to go to. From Fort Lauderdale right now, nonstop, round trip, $173.
That's my hometown.
That is your hometown. Go visit your relatives. You'll have a good time there. I love it there. You can go out west to the West Coast. Typically, these flights are significantly more. Right now, you can go from Fort Lauderdale to Portland, Oregon, nonstop round trip, $198, or San Francisco, nonstop round trip, $148. These are on Alaska Airlines. I've flown Alaska. It's a good airline. You know, people are talking about San Francisco. It's, you know, it's a horrible place. There's crime, there's filth, there's homeless, whatever. Maybe so, maybe not. You know, people who live there say it's not as bad as the media reports. But keep in mind, Napa is just north of San Francisco. If you don't want to stay in the city, rent a car. $148 flight? I mean, go to Napa. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy your life.
Dan, I'm sorry. Does that include the luggage?
Well, only if you want to lose it. No. I think you can. It includes carry-on, on Alaska, but not checked. You know, okay. Anytime I give you the very, very cheap rate, usually it's an economy fare. It might not include everything. And I got one more incredible deal. If the wine in Napa is not good enough for you.
I doubt that.
Okay. And you got to go to Paris to get French wine. Right now, nonstop, round trip from Miami, $389 to Paris.
Oh, that's a great deal.
Okay, it's on French B, and this is no frills, okay? So you're going to pay extra if you want a reserved seat. You're going to pay extra for everything. But if a backpack on your back and some adventure in your step, you know, Paris, why not? Now, and again, these are winter prices, so it's a little chilly there. But we're in Florida. It's nice to kind of have a change. So anyway, what I want to also do is, of course, thank our sponsor, Retirement Network Advisors, Jupiter Joe Thomas. Not just a friend, he advises me. You could reach him at jupiterjoe.com. Tell him I sent you, and he will send you his free book. Trust me, it will help you retire like it helped me. Also, thanks to our guest, Mike Schmidt, Community Director for Papa's Pilar Rum. Mike, how do we find information about you again, your company?
You can go check us out at shoppopspilarrum.com or sign up for our Hemingway Social Club, and you'll receive all our new information and releases coming out.
Awesome. And my co-host, Doris Muscarella. We can reach you at?
Doris Muscarella at golfcharitytournaments.com.
Fair enough. Also, of course, facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow. Like the page. You'll know who our guests are going to be every week. Next week, I will be in Punta Cana. In the Dominican Republic. I'll be back in time for the show, so we'll be talking a little bit about my fishing and rum drinking and whatever in Punta Cana. You won't want to miss it. So in the meantime, make sure that you tune in again, same time, same place next week for another episode of the Golf and Travel Show. And in the meantime, hit them straight.
I'm sitting in the railway station, got a ticket for my destination.
Thanks for listening to the Golf and Travel Show hosted by Dan Shube. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit him straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of the Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.